Hello again, my plastic forks, and welcome back to Chuck E. Cheese. Today we are going to be talking about a YouTuber I actually used to look up to a bit when I started my own YouTube channel. I'd really appreciate it if you watched until the end before commenting, because I cover a lot of things and my stances on some of the situations aren't necessarily clear from the beginning, because this is why Twitter canceled Shane Dawson, not why Mango Adele canceled Shane Dawson. There's a lot of stuff I could go over, so in no particular order, this is why Shane Dawson is canceled. Let's start with his blackfacing because, ouch.
This is a story all about how my life got twisted upside down, and I'd like to take a minute, just sit right there, and tell you how I became the prince of a town called Bel-Air.
Bum, 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 bum. There's nothing added to the skit of comedic value by blackfacing. There's no reason he needed to paint himself black, so I'm just kind of wondering why he took the extra effort to paint himself black and put on a costume. Even if it did add to the skit, obviously it wouldn't be okay, but that just makes me question it even more.
My seventh favorite bodily fluid! Oh, nigga bitch monkey woman, you're the best! I'm gonna eat this.
I think this clip speaks for itself just fine.
You should be!
I'm sorry, when I become Nikki, I just get so angry.
I'm including this one mostly because I'd honestly just really like context for this clip because I'm just confused.
The word of the day is... nigga!
The way he says it loudly and proudly is kind of funny, but not in a laughing with him way, and more of a laughing at him kind of way. Alright, let's get into the next topic, and that's Nancy behavior. Now, personally, I don't think Shane Dawson is actually a Nance. I just think he has a very bad sense of humor and says a lot of unacceptable jokes. And instead of admitting his jokes are bad, he doubles down and tries to defend them, and that's what makes him look Nancy.
Wait, Lucy, let's get real.
That's so embarrassing.
We want to know. We have a question.
What is it? Very important question. And you don't need to feel shy about it.
No, you really... you
it's really, natural.
It's natural. Is there anybody around? No?
It's natural for a girl at your age.
Yeah. So we want to talk to you. We want to explain what sex is to you.
Man.
We did get real quiet.
Where's the other peep? We should probably explain.
Oh, yeah. We'll use peeps. Okay, well, one peep and then we'll use you.
Oh.
Okay, so I'll just pretend like that's, you know, I mean, that works.
Lucy, this happens.
See, oop.
And then you're so happy and you're an adult. I can't believe I'm endorsing this. Look what you've turned me into.
So Lucy, does that make sense?
Can you reenact it for us?
But Lucy, listen, you should be in love and you should preferably be married and hopefully not have any kids.
Okay.
And you should definitely be over the age of like 24, 25.
And he should put a ring on it.
And he should put a dick ring on it. No, I'm kidding. No, you don't know what that is. You shouldn't know what that is.
Okay.
Now, are you on your period right
Stop
now?
Stop it. What?
I'm trying to get answers.
No. How old are you?
I'm not going to give you anything.
So close.
How old are you?
I'm 12.
She's
this
on period,
feels very.
Right?
No, what?
Are you? No, you're not on your period? You bleed.
No.
Now listen, you have a boyfriend, right?
Yeah.
Now what did I tell you? When he says, can I put it in, you say?
No.
Good. High five, girlfriend. Now when he says, what about just in your mouth, you say?
No.
No.
You say, I bite.
Okay, so the girl is clearly very uncomfortable. I know I personally kind of laugh and brush stuff off like this when I'm uncomfortable. You can see she doesn't really know how to react in this situation and kind of just wants to change the topic and move on. It's not acceptable to give this type of talk to anyone except, you know, your kids when it's time to give the talk. As well as the way they gave it wasn't really great. And asking her personal questions like if she's on her period is just... weird. Now, I do want to note this is Shane's cousin, so they are at least related. However, that doesn't make it very much better. And he still chose to upload this on YouTube, which, in my opinion, is the weirdest part of all of this.
Child was probably 6 years old, and I was taking a picture of something, and the kid turns to me and goes, oh, are you Instagramming? And first of all, how does a 5-year-old, 6-year-old know what Instagram is?
Right.
Which is terrifying.
Mm-hmm.
Second of all, I... was embarrassed because, yes, I was, and it was a picture of my salad. And the six-year-old girl goes, oh, how many followers do you have? I have 125,000.
No.
Her dick was almost as big as mine.
Really?
And I said, okay, little big dick, why do you have so many followers? And she goes, oh, I'm a cheerleader. And I'm like, oh, really? And she shows me her Instagrams, which are like, first of all, I don't know if I'm allowed to say this, but like, she's like sexy. She's like sexy.
You're disgusting.
I know. Listen, we've talked about pedophilia before.
No, this before. Is the, Shane, like, like, do not say this. And like, I don't even want to talk about it. Like, you will get arrested. Like, he kind of can.
Listen,
he allegedly has this justification for pedophilia.
Okay.
And it's so disturbing. And like, I just pretend that he doesn't.
Okay, wait, no. Let me explain.
Oh, God.
Here's my justification for pedophilia.
I can't.
Here's my thing. People have foot fetishes. People have fetishes about, you know, everything. Fine, everybody do your thing. So why is it when somebody looks at Google's, like, naked baby on Google and jerks off to it, they can get arrested?
Because,
I don't understand
because
that. Here's the worst part of it. I actually went to Google and I'm like, I kind of want to see.
You can get arrested.
I know, but I just wanted to see, like, okay, let me just pretend, let me pretend like I'm a pedophile for a sec. So I typed in naked baby. First of all, they were sexy. Okay, back to the Instagram. So I look at this little girl's pictures, and she had makeup on. She had her tongue out. She was doing, like, the peace sign. She was doing the backflip.
Is she, like, Honey Boo Boo? Is she fat?
I mean, yet again, he's clearly joking, but it's not funny. The thing is, he makes a joke, right? He calls the six-year-old sexy. That's supposed to be a joke. But instead of being like, oh, yeah, you know, that was a bad joke, we should cut that, that was stupid thing for me to say, he doubles down and defends his joke, and he gets defensive when his co-host is like, hey, you know, that's not something you really want to say. So that's really the issue here. I am not okay with the stuff he said at all, and he reacted to the situation incredibly poorly. Here he's jokingly jerking off to Willow Smith, and again, it's obviously a joke, but it's not a joke you want to make. It's just not a good look. Now let's talk about false allegations. If you've been on YouTube for a while, you know that false allegations plague this platform. Basically what happened is about a year ago, a beauty YouTuber named Tati got angry at James Charles because he did a brand deal with a vitamin brand that wasn't her brand. She decided to make a 45-minute long video, which, by the way, was monetized, which I find very interesting. It basically, quote-unquote, exposing James Charles. Most of this stuff was proven false, by the way. She spends most of her time saying that James Charles is a fake friend and a clout chaser and all that, and then at the end puts in some predator allegations. Which I find interesting that that wouldn't be her biggest concern, but aside the point. Jeffree Star then starts, you know, harassing James and, you know, saying he assaulted people and stuff like this and spreading false allegations, which I'm sure was for attention. Jeffree, you're gonna get your own video next week, so don't you worry. So Shane Dawson was doing this series called The Beautiful World of Jeffree Star at the time with Jeffree when all of this was happening. So he was well aware of everything going on with James Charles. And his series on people like The Mind of Jake Paul, The Beautiful World of Jeffree Star, the Tana Mojo series, they're all supposed to be real and talk about, I don't know if you can hear the thunder in the background, and talk about, sounds scary. Unfortunately, this clearly isn't it. They only really talk about makeup and they keep things very lighthearted and they don't go into the things that people actually want to see about Jeffree Star. He should not have branded the series as, you know, kind of like the truth about Jeffree Star because it really wasn't. And he supported Jeffree with these false allegations against James Charles and stabbed someone he called a friend in the back. Both of them had called James Charles a friend. They both stabbed him in the back. Recently, because of his restock for the Conspiracy Palette, which is a collab he did with Jeffree Star, people have been questioning the whole James Charles situation. And he addressed it on Twitter by saying James deserved, and I quote, a slice of humble pie. Which I find very interesting coming from somebody who's done blackface and sexualized children. This response is why people are bringing up old things he did. Usually I'm like, hey, you know, don't bring up old stuff a YouTuber did. But the reason people are doing this is because it's to prove he's a hypocrite with the situation that's currently going on. There are so many other instances of Shane doing problematic things. If I were to include all of them in a video, the video would be hours long, and I'm gonna be honest, I can't be asked to do that. I'm sure you can find stuff like that online. So instead, let's look at the apology that he posted 2 days ago of the time I'm recording this.
So, sorry. So first, let's start with blackface. Blackface was something that I did a lot. Like, I did it a lot on my channel, and there's no excuse for it. There's literally no excuse. I made a video 6 years ago talking about it, and I gave excuses, and I knew it was wrong, and I knew I would never wanted to do it again, but I didn't do the work. I didn't actually look into the history of it and why it's so wrong and why people were so upset. Because my excuse, oh, I was just being funny. I love black people. I'm not racist. I was trying to be funny. Like, all of that is stupid and wrong. And I put that onto the internet as an adult. And that is insane.
Okay, I can agree with this bit, yeah.
And I think I was taking everything as an attack, which is so stupid. Like, looking back, that is stupid. I was taking it as an attack. Like, I'm not racist, leave me alone, I'm not racist. And, you know, it's like, okay, but look what you're making, Shane. Like, that, I don't know how I didn't see that. That is scary.
I know this is a problem that a lot of YouTubers have, unfortunately, and it's a problem on this platform as a whole, where people see criticism as harassment. We've seen this obviously in like the Susie Liu case. I'm not gonna blame it on the traumatic things that happened to me. I personally used to struggle with this when I was, you know, in high school, because I was a very defensive person and I didn't like criticism, and, you know, I would double down and defend myself doing bad things because I thought people were attacking me. Obviously, I've grown past this now, and I actually welcome criticism, valid criticism, obviously. And I think criticism is what helps us grow as people and as content creators.
So there's a clip that has been going around again. A few years ago is when it came out, and they cut out all the parts where I said, you know, pedophilia is disgusting, and they put it together, and it made it seem like I was, you know, talking about how it's normal. So gross, I would never say that. But also, I shouldn't have been joking about it anyways.
Yes. But no, even with the context, it just does not look very good, Shane.
Which is my problem, my fault. So I'm sorry if you heard that. There's also other ones too. I mean, and that's something I have addressed before, but my childhood, my past, I've had a lot of pain. I've had a lot of bad things happen to me. I've had a lot of issues with my family. And I took that pain and I turned it into jokes. And I think instead of joking about them so much, I probably should have just went to therapy earlier and talked about them. I swear on my life, I am not somebody who would ever talk about a child, like in seriousness. I would never talk about a child in any way that was inappropriate. That is disgusting, that is gross, it is not something I would ever do. It is something I did for shock value or because I thought it was funny or like, oh my God, my child molester character or whatever. It's all gross and I promise that is not real. That is not me.
Listen, Shane, I know a lot of bad things have happened to you, but putting that in your video makes it sound like an excuse. Listen, Shane, a lot of bad things have happened to me too. I've gone through a lot of traumatic things. I've been through a lot myself. And here's the thing, I have been canceled before, yes, believe it or not. I used to be relevant in cosplay as Y. And you know what? I took responsibility. And I didn't say, hey, it's because I went through something bad. I said, hey, I was just being an asshole. There's no excuse. And there's a lot of things in my personal life I still probably could and will be canceled for.
I'm aware that I hold my friends or people I care about to a lower standard than I hold other people. That's wrong, and I'm so sorry. I think I get attached to people who have a heart, and maybe it's covered in a lot of stuff, and maybe they have a lot of issues, but I almost feel like I am attracted to other broken people who have issues, and I want to help them, I want to fix them, or I want to help people see a better side of them, and I'm aware that I'm friends with some people that, you know, have done some bad things on the internet.
This hits really close to home. I'm drawn to people who have the same bad traits as I once had because I want to help, because I kind of understand where they're coming from and I want to see them succeed. Now, this has caused me immense amount of problems. I've recently been shoved away by some people that I felt like this about. People that are considered problematic and I know do some toxic things that I tried to help, and it was stupid of me to assume that I could do anything to help. And they've pushed me away, and I've had to accept that and move on. And I think that's what you need to realize. If people don't want to change, then you can't make them change, and you need to move on to people you actually can help. You can't help people who don't want help. You can't keep trying to help people like Trisha and Jeffrey who show no interest in changing. I'm sorry, but this is facts. This is one of the hardest lessons that I have ever had to learn in my life, and it's still something I struggle with. Sometimes you can't fix people. They just don't want to be fixed. I still struggle so much and empathize with people that I really shouldn't, because I know deep down they could be a good person, but they're choosing not to. And I know, it's hard, it hurts. You see the good in everybody. I understand where you're coming from completely, but Shane, you just gotta let go and move on, because they are holding you down, and you are letting yourself down, and you're letting your community down when you support these people. All right, so I've seen the entire apology and the entire situation, and these are my final thoughts. I do believe that he's being genuine, and you guys can shit on me for that. That's whatever. Maybe I'm too empathetic. Even though I come across as incredibly empathetic, I do experience empathy, and I do understand why people do things a lot of the time. And I've been in similar situations, though, like I said, I was a lot younger, smaller, and didn't do nearly as bad of things. But I remember when I got called out, I was 16 years old, and I had a panic attack so bad that I had hives on my legs for 6 months from stress. You guys can hear the thunder in the background. It really adds to the ambiance, doesn't it? And I understand, and I've learned and I've grown from that, and I feel like if he truly wants to learn and grow from that, that he can too. He wants to make everyone happy, but the issue is he's playing all sides. Basically, Shane is playing all sides because he wants to make everyone happy, but in the end, this just hurts people. You need to make a stand. You can't just be in the middle, or people are just going to be hurt. I can genuinely empathize with a lot of the stuff he says. I mean, obviously, I can't relate to having a racist or Nazi past, but I can understand how he feels emotionally. I think the reason he keeps saying he's a good person isn't to reassure us, it's to reassure himself, because it's pretty obvious he hates himself right now. And while he shouldn't be saying that in this video, because again, it looks like he's trying to reassure us, I'm pretty sure that's actually not his intention. I find the ambiance of this video, I swear on my life, the thunder just really adds to this. I find it very difficult to hate people, and I find it difficult even to dislike people. The most you'll usually get from me is I will just want to avoid you and avoid being around you, and that's about it. So, is Shane Dawson the fakest YouTuber ever, or someone filled with love and regret? Only time will tell. I know this is a bit more of a serious video than usual, but I like to speak my mind on things that resonate with me. So I really hope that this take on the whole situation was at least interesting, and maybe you related to it. Here's the thing, YouTube is where I speak my mind, and it's where I put my feelings, because I'm not really great at expressing myself emotionally, because I kind of grew up in a place where having emotions were bad. You'd get the yells if you showed emotions. So YouTube is kind of the place where I put all the stuff that I don't feel comfortable just saying, and so sometimes there will be a more serious video because I need it for my own mental health. I really appreciate it if you watch this whole thing, and any support on this video would be greatly appreciated, because I was kind of nervous to post it. Anyways, as always, leave a like, subscribe with notifications on, and I will catch you on the flip side.